The direct route is usually the faster one, but you can often reach your destination easier and more efficiently if you make several stops. Are these vacation tips, or are we learning something about direct and alternating currents here? What the tech? An electric current is generated when charge carriers perform a directed movement. Electric currents flow in two different ways, either as direct current or as alternating current. If the flow of charge does not change direction, this is direct current. In this case, there is also no change in polarity or current level. Direct current is used in mobile electrical appliances, for example. These usually have batteries or accumulators that supply a constant direct current. The active electronics integrated in electrical appliances usually also require direct currents. This is why many stationary electrical appliances have rectifiers that convert the alternating current of the European power grid into pure direct current. But for mass power supply in the industrial age, our power requirements are often too high for batteries and accumulators. Ultimately, alternating current has prevailed, and this is what comes out of power outlets in every household today. An advantage of alternating current is that it can be produced in large quantities, for example, in hydroelectric and wind power plants. Here, the rotation of permanent magnets generates a changing magnetic field, and therefore a change in polarity and alternating current. The applied voltage can be increased and decreased flexibly and with low losses using a transformer. The alternating current can then be easily distributed to households via distribution boxes. So-called voltage losses are significantly lower with alternating current than with direct current. Do you know which two Americans wanted to implement direct current and alternating current, respectively? Want to find out more about this topic? Write in the comments exactly what you want to know. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel